Tennis Warehouse is super excited that Yonex has sent us two brand new prototypes of the E-Zone line. Troy and I headed down to the court for an hour hitting session, testing all of our different strokes to get our first impressions of these rackets. Now, Troy, I thought we would be the perfect two playtesters for this playtest as we are current E-Zone users. I use the 100 and you use the extended 98, so we have a lot of history with this racket. I've used the last three iterations, so I was super excited to see how this update would turn out, and I have to say I am not disappointed. When we first started hitting, even that first ball, I was instantly connected with the frame. Now, we don't know any official specs or any new technologies, but I have to say, with this 100, I feel like the specs have remained pretty similar to the past iterations.
Yeah, from that first strike of the ball at the baseline, definitely could tell I was using an E-Zone 98. The feel of this racket is pretty solid, very stable feeling up in the hoop. It felt a little firmer, maybe, and I don't know if that was just string tension or just the way the hoop's designed, but a very nice feel right off the bat. Good, crisp, clean feel. And then one thing, just looking at the frame, is it does seem to have a little bit more of a rounder shape than the previous current E-Zone right now, a little bit more like the DR, the AI.
Yeah, for me on the baseline, I thought it offered that great combination of control and power that I love from the E-Zone line. And I thought that, like kind of how you mentioned, that for me the previous iteration was a little stiffer up in the tip of the racket. And this one wasn't as stiff. And when I did hit the ball up at that tip area, I was getting a little bit of feedback, but it wasn't necessarily any bad feedback. It was actually, I kind of liked it because I was able to feel where the ball was landing on the string bed and I could adjust. And so I didn't have any vibrations. It was very, very comfortable.
Yeah, a nice, I would say, responsive feel. So nice, solid, firm, responsive feel. I could tell where the ball was landing within the string bed, sweet spot or slightly out of it. And when I went to hit a couple, you know, touch or drop shots, I felt like I was getting good connection to the ball just right off the bat.
Yeah, this racket's super comfortable. I was really impressed when we came up to net. For some reason, I was really connecting well with my volleys. The racket felt super solid and stable on contact. And I felt like I could do a variety of volleys with it. I had nice depth when I was really punching the ball, and I was even throwing in a touch volley or two.
Yeah, up at net, I felt like the crisp, responsive feel carried on. It seemed, you know, pretty well connected, point and shoot. There was decent stability for the E-Zone 98, not typically being a really heavy racket like I typically play with. I felt like I was blocking the ball back with ease. You were drilling a couple at me pretty hard, and it hung in there, so.
Yeah, when it came to serves for me, it played very similar to the previous version. I like that I was able to get the racket up and going over my head, generate racket head speed, very important for me, especially when I'm playing matches, that I don't have any arm fatigue. And I thought I could hit, you know, a variety of serves. I had that power when I needed to on a first. I could kick a second serve and then throw in a slice to keep my opponent guessing.
Yeah, on the serve, the first thing I noticed with the serve and when I was hitting overheads is when I really went to flatten the ball, pancake it, had a nice loud pop to it, like a nice, just a really, really, seemed like it was getting a lot of pace on the ball. So that was a nice thing that I noticed. Maybe not as much free power as my E-Zone 98 Plus. I was trying to hold the bottom part of the racket to get that extra leverage, but nice, yeah.
One of the big factors of me when I come to choosing a racket is how it performs on returns. It's one of my strongest shots, and so I want the racket to really accentuate that, and I loved it on returns. We didn't hit a ton of returns. You know, I got at least 10, 15 returns in, and kind of like that volley, it just felt really solid to me. I knew where the ball was landing on the string bed, and I could direct that power or create my own power and create a really offensive return with it.
Yeah, fast feel, really quick. I felt like when I really tried to rip a return really hard on the forehand, I had control, it was dropping in, and it felt like it was decently stable. It's not that mashing power that you get from a V-Core Pro 330, but it was stable enough that when I needed to block or chip the ball back, the racket didn't seem to flutter.
Lastly, I wanted to touch on the cosmetics of these E-Zones. Now, this is not the final cosmetic, this is just the prototype, but I really like how Yonex put green and blue pops in each racket, kind of keeping us guessing on what this final cosmetic is gonna look like.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to what they got for us.
The new E-Zone family of rackets is scheduled to launch in January of 2020, so be sure to check out our website for our full written and video reviews of these frames. For more information on anything tennis related, please check us out at Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.